Jesus will turn all your sorrows into joy. Jesus is by your side. Whatever you ask, He will give it to you. Our precious, precious friend, it's such a joy to be with you today, to pray with you, and also to share with you what a wonderful God we have, who cares for you, who has counted your hair, and who has seen your tears, and who is a very present help in times of trouble. Truly, He is a righteous judge, and when we think that we have not done enough to earn His favor, that's the time He comes and showers His grace upon us and gives us every blessing in an abundant measure. Count your blessings. Name them one by one, and it'll surprise you what the Lord has done. And when it surprises you, that's the time faith builds in your heart and you're able to believe God for greater things in your life. And that's what God has in store for you. Greater things. Greater things. He loves you. Let not your heart be troubled. Truly, when you honor Him for the small things that He has done for you in your life, He will make you receive in abundance. All that He needs from you is gratitude. When the people who have everything see that the people are grateful for what they have received from them, and when they hear a word, thank you, their heart melts and they want to do much more for those people. Even in our land in India, during a Christmas celebration, the government of our state arranged a big Christmas celebration, and the leader of the state, whom you call the governor, was there at that event. And as I stood up and began to narrate all that he had done for the people of the state during that year, and I said, "Sir, we want to thank you. We want to thank you. We want to thank you, because that's what Christmas is all about." He shed tears. He said, "In all my life, I have never heard anyone saying thanks." If the leader of a state would be so moved with the word thank you, how much more the Almighty God? But then, when the other speakers gave a lot of requests, petitions, he said, "I'm sanctioning them straight away for the Christian community of our land." Yes, my friend, that's what God does. We are grateful to you, Lord. As we say it every morning, as we say it every moment, you will see God's abundant power coming upon you to fulfill all that you need. And you will have everything in abundance. Let not your heart be troubled. Well, that's how our family has been blessed all these days. We have a wonderful verse which says, "In everything, give thanks." In everything, at all times, give thanks. Well, having said that, as we look at the life of David, every moment he praised God. He danced in the street before the ark of God. And he humbled himself so much, his wife thought he humiliated himself by dancing before all his subjects, even though he was king. And she said, "You have belittled yourself as king." by dancing in the street before the eyes of all your women. But then he said, I would even become more humble. And I will go to the dust before my God, because he has been so gracious to take me from behind the sheep and put me on the throne. So that's the heart which protected him from all evil. No enemy could overcome him. They all came, his own son came, but God protected him. In everything, give thanks. So, have you had that experience in your life at any point of time?
Especially, I loved my mother so much. After I lost her, I was only 21 years old. And that time, our son was born. He was a baby. And I was crying and crying and crying, thinking of my mother. And then you said one day, why are you crying, Evangeline? Why not you thank God for all the blessings that God has already given you, God had already given you in your life? Then, only then I realized how much the Lord had blessed me. And I started to thank God. Lord, thank you for all the blessings that you've given me in my life. And I thank you for the blessings you're going to give me in future. And from that day on, I literally saw blessings coming in search of me. And till today, the Lord is blessing me. I should say I am a blessed woman. Only after thanking God.
Because you have a blessed husband. What about you, Stella?
I read the verse, with prayer and thanksgiving, present your request to God. So with that, whenever I pray, I start the prayer with thanking God for everything that he's done for me, thanking for the blessings that he has given me, thanking him for the freedom that I have in him. So with that, when I pray, I feel like I don't have to lift the burden alone. So when I tell everything to God, when I pray to him, I feel like I can just let go of all my burdens because he will take care of them. And when I thank him, I remember what he has done for me. So that gives me peace that he will do more for me as he has done before.
Wonderful. There's a difference between praise and thanks. Praise is praising him for what he is and who he is. You're a great God. You're a wonderful God. You're a supernatural God. You're a faithful God. You're a gracious God. Long-suffering and so on. But thanking God is for what he has done and what he is going to do. So, as we thank him for what he has done, he says, what can I do for you? Then we say, Lord, these are our requests. And then he sends his peace into us, according to Philippians 4, 6 and 7. And the peace that passes all understanding makes every blessing come alive in our lives. And that's how we supernaturally receive God's blessings. What is impossible with man is possible with God. That's when the impossible becomes a possible, as God does the possible in the midst of our impossible situations. And it's amazing how David was thanking God. And I believe that this thanksgiving comes because of our love for God. David was all alone, but he loved God with all his heart. That's why the Lord says, love the Lord with all your heart, with all your strength. And I think that loving God comes to us when we long for God to do everything in our lives. When we say, Lord, I can't do anything, you have to do everything. And that brings great love in our hearts, because when I gave my life to Christ, he brought me out of all my addictions and so on. And then I was praying, Lord, I want your power. I want to see great things. I want to become a somebody in this world. But then at that moment, through prophecy, the Lord spoke to me through my father. And he said, my son, you had many, many friends in this world. But from now on, I will be your only friend. You will never see your friends around you anymore. Because I was spending time with my friends and living in the unrighteous world. But then amazingly, all those relationships just vanished. I still do not know how it went. It was only the Lord. And every day I would talk to him and tell him, Lord, this is before me, help me. The presence of God would fill me, and he would direct my paths, and everything I would do would be a success. So I would thank him, thank him, thank him, and greater blessings would come. So it's more loving him, trusting him, and having him as our friend and talking to him at all times. Well, our dear friends, we are now going to have a short break, and we are going to come back, and we're going to talk to you more about this. And I believe you will receive him as your own friend.
I am Audrey Furtado. I am associated with the Jesus Cause for last 24 years. I got married in 1999. God has given me two beautiful children, healthy children, intelligent children. Both the children are young partners. We are doing well. My elder son is in the 10th standard. He is a very good artist. He has also participated at state level drawing competition. My daughter is also coming up. She is a good swimmer, and she has been participated at state level for swimming. People do appreciate my children, and I also tell them it is because of Jesus Cause Beta. During my graduation, I felt like doing my post-graduation, and during my post-graduation, there were 13 people ahead of me for the admission. Now, losing all the hopes that I would not get for post-graduation, since there was only one seat for the outstates, and I being a Goan will not get it, and 13 students in front of me or ahead of me, I contacted Jesus Calls Prayer Tower. The prayer warriors gave me a reply saying that you will definitely get the seat. Go with faith. Keeping the promise in mind, I went for admission, and what a luck, I got the seat. The best seat in the best department, horticulture department, which was considered as one of the best department in our college. Gradually, I passed out my post-graduation. I came out with flying colors. I got a permanent job of a teacher in 1997. Till date, I am working as a teacher. God has blessed me immensely. I have not asked for it, but he has given me. I have prayed. Whatever I have prayed through prayer tower, I have got till date. My heartfelt thanks to Brother Paul, his whole family, the prayer warriors, the entire Jesus Calls ministry. Thank you once again.
My dear friends, I want to welcome you to the Jesus Calls Prayer Tower. Yes, indeed, it's a place of hope where you can pour out your heart, and there'll be somebody, a prayer intercessor, to cry along with you, filled with the love and compassion of Jesus Christ. Jesus said, if two agree, it shall be done by my Father in heaven. And we are here to agree with you and cry with you. Yes, indeed, Jesus Christ has shed his blood. He has cried for you. And even today, the Holy Spirit prays for you. And he prays through his servants from their spirits. You may say, I'm not able to pray myself. My heart is broken. Yes, indeed, we are here to join you in faith and pray, mentioning the word from the Lord through the scriptures and giving you faith to pray along with us. And if two agree, it shall be done by my Father in heaven, says the Lord. Come to the prayer tower and we will pray along with you. Or write to us and we will pray along with you. Or call us. The number that's on the screen, please call. It's available 24 hours and somebody will speak in your language and pray along with you. And the Lord Jesus will bring answers to you. So use this ministry and be blessed in double measure. Hello friends, we are back again to talk to you about having God as your friend. Is it possible? Yes, it is. The love for God and the yearning to receive every blessing from God makes God your friend. And then you're able to trust Him and the miracles begin to happen as you thank Him for what He does and what He's going to do. That's how faith comes in. Faith moved by love. So, as I was reading the scripture today, 1 Samuel 18 and verse 5 onwards, it talks about David, 1 Samuel 18 verse 5. Whatever Saul sent him to do, David did it so successfully that Saul gave him a high rank in the army. This pleased all the people and Saul's officers as well. Well, David never had any experience as a government official, as an army general, or as even a warrior. But then the Bible says, whatever David did, he did it so successfully that automatically he was given a high rank in the army by the king. And that pleased all the people. People were not jealous of him. Everyone was pleased with David and every officer of Saul. Isn't that fantastic? And then I read the reason for this. If you read verse 12 in the same chapter, it says, because the Lord was with David. The Lord was with David. And secondly, in everything he did, he had great success because the Lord was with him. And when the king saw how successful he was afraid of him. The king was afraid of David because he was so successful. And of course, he was successful because the Lord was with him. And it was because David loved God. And the Bible says again in verse 20, Saul's daughter, the king's daughter, Michal, was in love with David. So he had all the love. The king's daughter loved him. The people loved him. The king's officers loved him. And wherever he went, God gave him success because God was with him. And it was just because David loved God and said, you're my friend. And you'll be my only friend. His only friend was God. He never trusted in anyone. Even his brothers were criticizing him. His father never even thought about him when Samuel came to their home to find a king amongst the children of Jesse, his father. And finally, when Samuel rejected all the sons of Jesse, his father said, there's one fellow who is behind the sheep. But he's not a kingly candidate. But yet when he came, Samuel anointed him because God had chosen David. David's only friend was God. And that really made him get the love of everyone, favor of everyone. And he was successful in everything. And that's exactly what God wants to give you, my friend. He wants to make you successful in everything. Wherever your officers send you, wherever the government sends you, wherever your family sends you, wherever your ministry sends you, wherever God sends you, you will be successful. You will be successful. And the king became jealous. The Bible says the king became jealous because everyone was singing praises about David, and they said, the king Saul slayed thousands, but David, tens of thousands. So the king said, they gave me only thousands, but they have given tens of thousands to David. And he became jealous. And when he became jealous, an evil spirit came upon the king. Jealousy is terrible. Today we see jealousy in the place of work, jealousy even in the home. Relatives say, how come they are more successful? How come whatever he does prospers? How come she gets scholarship? Jealousy. Have you seen that, sweetie, in the world?
Yeah. When people get jealous of other people's success, other people's popularity, how other people, how that person gets the love of all the people around them and nobody pays attention to them. So when that happens, they get distracted of their own life. They focus on that, and they don't, and they start spreading rumors, they gossip, and that takes up their life, and they're not able to perform well. They lose their success, and they lose their way. So I think jealousy affects their life in that way.
And they become so weak, they can't perform. And here it says, because of that, an evil spirit comes upon that person who is jealous. And do you have anything to say about that, Evangeline?
In James 3:16, the Bible says, where the spirit of jealousy is, there is disorder. And when we feel bad about others or complain about others, there is disorder. And confusion, fighting,
and that person is not able to perform. Everything that person does is a failure. But here, when that evil spirit came upon the king Saul, because he became jealous of David, it was only David who was called to play the harp. And when he played the harp, when David played the harp, the evil spirit left the king. So he even helped the king who was jealous of him. The power to drive evil spirits came out of David. You know the reason? He was not afraid of jealousy. He always said in verse 23 of 1 Samuel chapter 18, I am only a poor man and little known. He says, I'm a poor man, I'm little known. Even after he became so famous, when all the women of his kingdom were singing praise to him in the streets, when all the king's officials were honoring him, when all the people loved him, when the king's daughter loved him, he said, I'm only a poor man, I'm little known. In his eyes, he was so humble. He said, I'm a poor man, but God has lifted me. God has lifted me. The love for God and honoring God for everything. Never honoring his success. My friend, this is the spirit that God is going to give you to make you successful. And we're going to pray together. All of us need this grace to be successful in everything that we do and to get the love of everyone, the praise of everyone. But yet our eyes will be not be upon them, not be upon the success, but upon the Lord who will be our only friend. Shall we pray together? Father, as we pray together, we pray that you will be honored in our minds, in our hearts, in our spirits, in our words, in our thoughts, in our actions, in our work.
Mm-hmm.
And we will say, without you, Lord Jesus, we can do nothing. Because you of your sacrifice on the cross, we receive grace upon grace. And because of that, we receive blessing of one blessing. We will honor you. We will trust you. And you will perfect everything for us and through us, Lord. Even today, everyone who says, I am afflicted because of jealousy, Lord, give them the power to break that spirit of jealousy. Let thy Holy Spirit be upon them, that they would pray and sing and thank you, Lord. And the evil spirits that are against them will be broken. The people who are against them will turn to them and honor them, Lord. Give them that grace today. Let them experience it. We give you all the glory. And if there is any fear in anybody's heart because of the jealous spirits that are against them, we command those spirits of fear to leave them. We command those spirits of weaknesses to leave them. And if that has affected their blood pressure or their bodies, let them be healed even now. Let them have no worries. Let them always say, I am a poor man, but God is thinking about me. My Lord loves me. He will take care of me. Give them that grace and that confidence. We give you all the glory, Lord. We bless them in Jesus' name. Give them a beautiful tomorrow and make them a great success in life. In Jesus' name, we humbly pray. Amen. Our precious friends, God has chosen you to be a great success. May God give you this grace and bless you abundantly. He is your friend. Talk to him, enjoy him, and enjoy everything he has for you. No man can put you down.
Kindly uphold this ministry with your generous offerings, which will help us reach the gospel to nook and corner of the world and bring happiness to millions. DD and checks can be drawn in favor of Jesus Calls. We also have a facility for you to send your valuable donations through debit card and credit card through our net banking via www.jesuscalls.org. Please send your donations to Jesus Calls, number 16, Dr. D.G.S. Dinakaran Road, Raja Annamalaipuram, Chennai 28. Jesus Calls, Karunya Nagar, Coimbatore 641-114. Email paul@jesuscalls.org. Our mission, not a single soul to be lost. Watch Jesus Calls program the same time tomorrow. Until then, may the Lord be with you.